earlier on. They're all in. Off and racing. Casino 17 began only fairly. Ginger Green and also Dig Deep from the inside. They were amongst the first to jump with Big Screen going up now. He's rushing forward. He's going to go up there and have a little look as well for the lead. Vane Tempest is going to be nice and handy as they settle properly into stride. They're being followed over on the outside next of all by Hardly Ever. Bold Success getting back between horses. Casino 17 making ground at the 1,000. Going up on the inside is next of all. And they're being followed further back by Son of Bacchus, who's out there a little deep. Dark Assault wider in behind those, then came Sentimental Hero back with Downforce, Holy Ghost. The Velvet Queen is back there next to last, in actual fact, in company with Roman Flirt. Well, Big Screen takes off and goes past the 700 and established a break of about four, running second. Dig Deep down on the inside, being closely followed by Ginger Green, three deep outside of those. Hardly Ever as they approach the home turn, a length and a half. Casino 17, Vane Tempest dropping back through the field. Dark Assault wide on the course, then Son of Bacchus. Sentimental Hero locked up near the rail at the top of the straight. They balance up, 350 to go. Hardly Ever, Dig Deep come out after Big Screen. In behind them, Dark Assault starts to get around heels and runs on strongly. Hardly Ever hits the front. It's Hardly Ever with 120 left to go, leads the way. Casino 17's got a run. Here comes Casino 17, the Velvet Queen from nowhere. Whoa, what a great finish in the last. The Velvet Queen on the outside, lunging at Casino 17, made it awfully close, had so much momentum. The Velvet Queen might have got there. And behind them, close up, Hardly Ever and Sentimental Hero. Big finish. Behind them, next of all, Holy Ghost and Dig Deep. Followed further back behind them, Downforce. Gee, Dark Assault was there and all of a sudden wasn't in the last 50 because the race changed complexion so much. Big Screen, Ginger Green next home. Bold Success, the Velvet at the head of the others. Behind them, Vane Tempest. Followed further back by Son of Bacchus and one of the last home, Roman Flirt. Yeah, the Velvet Queen, what a finishing run. The Velvet Queen, Chris Parnham, picks off a double today here. He gets Pike in the last on Casino 17 and Sentimental Hero. Well, it really did change dramatically the last 100 of the race. They weren't in it, then they were. Casino 17 rushing through, the Velvet Queen. She's erupted late and has got there, nailing him on the line. And in the end, it was actually a short head. She came with such a rush, so much momentum that she has got there. The Velvet Queen. The mare by Universal Ruler, Chris Parnham. She had plenty behind her, but she was at least out there near the middle of the course as Casino 17 cut through inside of runners. Hardly Ever. And also Dark Assault were there, then all of a sudden they were gone. Sentimental Hero was running on, but it was the Velvet Queen that had such a great turn of acceleration. The turn of foot, breathtaking in the last of the day to win it by Universal Ruler from Double Black Velvet. Darren McCall of Chris Parnham over Casino 17 by Casino Prince from Tickle. Grant and Delana Williams and written by William Pike. So Pike, Parnham and also Brad Rawilla finished up with doubles here this afternoon at this Christmas Eve card. And 14 Sentimental Hero third. Joey has a party for Michael Grantham by Al Maher from Sentimental Star. 129.35 is the time there. 35.41 as Judge James Ryan signs off for the last time at Ascot today. And we wish James Jingo, as he's more affectionately known, all the best of luck in his next chapter of his handicapping career with the Victoria Racing Club. Okay, let's go down now to Bridge. He's got the last of the bonbons ready to go, and I'm sure that Big D Mac will be very, very keen to pop one down there after that victory.
Oh, well, I'm sure this is the best Christmas present he could ask for, the Velvet Queen finishing off like that. D Mac, we're getting into the festive spirit. Let's pop the bonbon. There we go, and he wins. I reckon it's a bottle opener in there, which will come in handy as well. What about this turn of foot from this horse?
Yeah, she's electric, isn't she? You know, she had no luck last start. She had got even a minuscule gap. I think she sort of probably gaps them. But anyway, yeah, it was good to... I would have hung Chris at the top of the straight. I really would have. But look, his hand was forced. I said to him in instructions, just make sure you're sort of in the three deep moving line, and you know, just be mindful you're following the right horse. And we weren't, but didn't matter in the end.
At what stage of the straight did you have concerns once she was out in the open, because she still had a mountain of horses to get past? But you must have a lot of confidence in the turn of foot she does have.
Oh yeah, look, I mean, you know, Blind Freddy, you know, any punter that follows her and has followed her career knows she's got a good turn of foot, and it's getting better and she's getting more mature. But look, the way the races have panned out today, it's been all but impossible to win from there. So it gives more merit to her performance. But look, she's a nice filly. She's still, in my opinion, 12 months off of, reaching anywhere near a ceiling. So, it's just very rewarding, because she's been super, super unlucky in most of her races. So,
what do you believe that ceiling is?
Oh, she's certainly sort of a stakes horse. There's no questions there. But look, we've just got to be patient and look after her. She's got a... Unlike her brother, I mean, her full brother, you know, he used to bounce and ride the speed, and he was just tough as all buggery. But she's, she's more a get back, and she's got just a fantastic turn of foot, probably the best turn of foot of any horse I've ever trained. So they excite you when they work. She's actually pretty relaxed in her work, but she's got some chinks in her armour, and we're still sort of holding her hand on the way through. But she'll be a stakes horse at some stage, just not quite yet.
As we round out our Christmas Eve meeting, what does Christmas look like at the McAuliffe household? Turkey, seafood, what's on offer?
Yeah, no, we get up and Emma and I will do, 100 plus horses at the farm, and just work.
It never stops. Well done on the win.
Thank you.
There is Darren McAuliffe. Over to Chris Parnham.
Well, Chris Parnham, we were taking our breath away, really, that turn of acceleration. What did it feel like?
Yeah, super. I always knew that she sort of had that sort of performance in her. She never got a crack at him the other day. And just today, it was a huge win. It's probably the best win of her career to come from where she did, and the turn of acceleration that she showed. And I just thought, at the top of the straight, I thought, I'm just too far from them to pick them up. But she was too good.
She had to spear off the corner to find a spot, and then she balances up. That last 200 is probably as good as you've felt most of the carnival.
No, she's right up there. I think she's got black type ability, so when she finally steps out to that sort of grade, I think she'll be right there.
Congratulations and Merry Christmas.
Same to you, mate. Thanks.
There is Chris Parnham, who rides the Velvet Queen to victory there in the last for Darren McAuliffe, who's having a bit of a laugh at the joke inside his Christmas cracker. On Sky Thoroughbred Central, thanks for your company, albeit just for the last. Hopefully you've managed to find a winner today, and good punting to you over this next festive period, and we'll be back during the week. Merry Christmas to you all.
The wine Christmas Day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Melikilikimaka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas to you.
Melikalikimaka is a thing to say on a bright Hawaiian Christmas day. That's the island greeting that we send to you from the land where palm trees sway. Here we know that Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Melikalikimaka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas to you. Christmas will be green and bright, the sun to shine by day and all the stars.